Hello friends, today in the follow-up of the previous video which I had done, and I had taken up nibs from the Nib Studio, the person Mr. Jaspreet Gill, and I had taken up two nibs last time, and this time again I am taking up two nibs from his collection, and this one is mounted on a Click pen, Click Aristocrat. It's a steel nib, and again on ASA Mist. This is an Indian pen company. This one is again a steel nib, both of them number 6 nibs. So let's come to the first grind. So while I write, can you guess which grind is this? This nib is a broad nib which has been ground to a oblique broad. The typical grind on an oblique broad would be, if you can see clearly, the nib has been ground obliquely so that the resting on the paper is at an angle. So you can't just write it perpendicular. You'll have to hold it at an angle and then put it in such a way so that this oblique surface is completely resting on the paper, and it would give you a grind which is maximum on these strokes and minimum on these strokes. So the line variation can be appreciated best in this way rather than horizontal and vertical. The nib has to be ground to the angle of the person holding the pen, as is with the architect grind. So you'll have to share certain details with the nib meister before he does this job. I've reviewed a couple of nibs from Mont Blanc, and there was a Pelican also which I had, which had an oblique medium nib. This is a buttery smooth nib. It involves a lot of discipline from the writer because you'll have to hold it at a very particular angle and you just can't play around with it. So that is what is necessary from your side. Otherwise it gives a good line variation, as you can see from here, and it's a joy to write. It gives a good character to the handwriting, and you can see the word formation is slightly different with the oblique broad. It's a lovely grind. So I asked the chap Jaspreet about his preference. Although I am in love with the oblique as well as the architect, his particular grind which he likes is the architect grind. I have reviewed one of his architect nibs earlier, and I must say that he does a great job with the architect grinds. At the same time, the nib which is very tough to be made is the which I reviewed last time was the needle point. That has been, as per the nib master, is a tough grind to do. Takes quite some time and takes quite a lot of finesse to attain that. When we come to the second one, of the two, I happen to like this more because of the crispness and the wetness of the line which it gives. This one is, this is a Yovo nib, which is a Goulet nib basically, from the Goulet pen company. This is again a Yovo steel nib. From the Goulet pen company. The pen is ASA Mist. This one was Elegant Teal from Krishna, and this is Private Reserve. Nipples blue, and there has been some hint of diamond soft mint also, but I'm not sure what proportion is from diamond. Now to the best part. This is a broad cursive nib on the front stroke, so you can see very thin lines on the horizontal and thick lines on vertical, but if you reverse the pen, it will write as simple broad. Now, this is a 2-in-1 grind on a same nib, and if the nib tipping is broad, it gives certain flexibility for the nib master to do that. You can see that this is a broad nib. So the lines with this This is with the side which is broad cursive, and on reverse side while on broad cursive you can expect, because of the sharp edges which has been cut on the side to make it a cursive, you can expect it to write with a bit of feedback. It's exceptionally wet, but it glides very well, giving you a very reassuring feel of the paper while writing. This is a 68 JSM Tomo River paper. On the reverse, it is fun, but it writes a bit on the drier side. And also, I enjoy the front grind on this better than the reverse grind. There is a slight drag while writing from the reverse because of the broad surface, while on the broad cursive surface just runs over the paper very beautifully. So this was the fourth nib which I had reviewed. I have reviewed four, and I expect a couple of them in the next video, and then we'll come to the giveaway. So there will be two nibs which will be given away. One would be the oblique broad, this one, and the second would be a broad stub from the Nib Studio, and that will be sent over by Jaspreet himself. The questions will be asked in the next video, which would be the part 3, and then we'll announce the giveaway also, and what are the rules for that. So let's see you the next time, and I hope you like this. Take care.